Come on, then. Let's go grab a Brahmin steak first thing. Is this another... Do I have another companion now? Kitsune. Her eyes are different colors. One of them brown is malm brick. I think malm brick is a brown brick. The other bright green. She has 80 hit points. Okay. We've got another companion. So we need to choose between her and Robo Brain then. Kitsune, Kitsune, I don't know. I'm pretty sure you wouldn't have been frozen in a cryo tank for no good reason. I'm interested in knowing what it was exactly you did before you were put on ice. Why do you care? It's in the past. We're on the road together. I want to know more about you. Well, I suppose there's no need for secrecy anymore. It's just hard to break a lifelong habit. You see, I was pretty much born a spy. There we go. Go on. My father was Chinese, but he and his family were no friends of the Chinese government. He was born in Beijing, but got the most important aspect of his education here, in the States. When he returned home and got a job as a public servant, he'd already been recruited by the Americans as an intelligence agent. I'm not overly... Ooh, I wonder if she can help us with the Chinese sub. I'm not overly familiar with the politics of your time, but I think I follow what you're saying. Your dad was Chinese, but he was secretly a spy for the Americans. So did the Chinese ever suspect him? My father worked at the Ministry of Agriculture for 38 years. Alright, I guess that's a no. So when did you enter the picture? Well, one day, an aide to the official my father was working for caught him making copies of secret documents. That couldn't have been good. Actually, it didn't turn out so bad. You see, she thought along the same lines as my father, and within a couple of months they were married. Some guys have all the luck, huh? They had me a year later. I was raised in China under the facade of a patriot. In school, I'd write about how China was strongest when unified, and how we'd continue to strive towards social equality. When I was older, I wrote for nationalist newspapers and participated in debates supporting the ruling party. Your parents took great pains to make sure your family's true loyalty stayed secret. All warfare is based on deception. My parents loved their country. They just hated the people who ran it and thought it would be better off as a democracy. The way they saw it, they weren't betraying China. They were working against a government they didn't believe was good for it. She's not gonna like that, huh? Go on. I married an official who worked for the Chinese Ministry of National Defense. I chose him because he was the most willing to talk about our work when we were together. So I played the role of the dutiful wife while secretly reporting relevant information back to my American superiors. But then things got complicated. How so? My father was contacted by Dr. Raynard Moldrake, an old colleague he had worked with during his time in the States. Dr. Moldrake urgently requested a private meeting, but my father was in poor health at the time and was in no condition to travel to America. Dr. Moldrake agreed to meet me in his place. So what happened? It turned out Moldrake was part of a top-secret project at a West Tech research facility in Southern California. The project had started off innocently enough as an attempt to find a way to make people immune to the new plague, but it quickly evolved into something more sinister. Something called Forced Evolutionary Virus, or FEV. Here we go, guys. Go on. It had the potential to greatly enhance a person's strength and intellect, but the FEV was dangerously unstable. Despite this, the military hoped to use it to create an army of super soldiers that could crush the Chinese. Dr. Moldrick was against the change in the project's direction, but kept his mouth shut out of fear for his life. But when he learned that the military was testing the virus on unsuspecting small American towns, he knew he had to take action. The world needed to know the truth. So that's when he contacted your father. Right. When I met him, he gave me a holodisk containing classified documentation of the FEV project. That put me in a rather difficult position. I could release the information contained in the holodisk and betray the country I'd sworn my loyalty to, or I could destroy the disk and bury the ugly truth from my people. Holy shit. Don't tell me. I sent the copies of the holodisc to just about every major news outlet in the world. It pretty much destroyed whatever sympathy the American government still had.
Wow.
I might have revealed the truth to the world, but I'm afraid I also set in motion its destruction. Things escalated quickly, and 8 months later the bombs were dropped. How did you end up in that tank where I found you? The American government was hunting for the person responsible for leaking the information. They finally caught up with me just before the end. They were already preparing to freeze me when the sirens first sounded. Probably to preserve me in case I had any more secrets I hadn't told them. Housewife. Right? Did you what? The fella caught up with me. They're already preparing to freeze me. Did you? It doesn't matter now. Everyone's dead. I know what you must be thinking, but you can't blame yourself for something like that. It's always easier not to accept responsibility. You couldn't have known. Besides, there were other conflicts besides the between the powers. They would have blown each other up sooner or later. It was only a matter of time. Humans are the worst things. I don't consider myself that bad. Nature's been trying to wipe us out for millennia. All these new diseases, natural disasters, we were some kind of evolutionary mistake. Maybe we came about too early or weren't supposed to come about at all. We've done more damage to this planet than any other thing living or dead. But we can atone for it. That's the special thing about us. You've got an awfully nice way of putting it. Thanks for hearing me out. I almost feel like I can move on. Say, since you were a spy, I'm sure you're pretty skilled at stealth and all that. Anything you can teach me? Yes, I've had quite a bit of practice with sneaking, lockpicking, and stealing. Here, let me show you a few things they didn't teach you in the books. You've got it now. Remember, practice makes perfect. Hey, thanks. It's about time we headed out. So we better at stealth? Wait, I thought I hit C. Where is that even? Sneak is at 36? Yeah. I don't know what I had it at before. What is it? You look like you have something to say. About your eyes. What about them? That's the name. What is the term for it? Heterochromia? Is that what you have? How would I know that? Right? Being a tribal and all that? Mine isn't a natural condition. The one on the left didn't belong to me. I lost the old one in an accident, and I've never learned to appreciate that until now. What do you mean? Ever since the transplant, I always felt like I was seeing the past in one eye and the present in the other, more so than ever now, and that helps me to carry on. We all have our ways of coping. I'm all ears. I guess stay close. Alright, I have your back. What do you need to know? What kind of weapons can you use? I have a black belt in Sanshou? Sanshou? Never heard of that. I can stab a man to death if the situation calls for it. Pistols, rifles, and the like I'm decent with. Okay. She didn't have anything. Okay, so she can carry up to 175. That's a pretty decent amount of what she can carry. Yeah, I'd say that's good. Now, if there's a romance available, like a romance option available, I probably can't take it because I'm technically still married, even though I'm a widower, I guess. Widowette? I don't know. we're unarmed, yeah, because she doesn't have anything. Distance. Tech who? It was attacking me. Ooh, she's got a necklace. Look at that. An expensive looking necklace made from silver, gold, and pressed diamonds. So that's cool. It's about time we found a female follower in this. I mean, I found one. It was my wife for like 30 minutes. Now what about these other two? This is not gonna be official, guys. I just wanna see what happens. If we can even talk to them. Proceed anyway. Dexter. Warning, no environmental rejection syndrome inhibitors were applied to the specimen. State of specimen is unknown. Please proceed to the cryo chamber for retrieval. Body of a white male lies naked inside. What, didn't I choose Dex? Dex was next to her. So that's Kitsune. Knew she was more than a housewife. See here. See, her tank was right next to Patrick's. That's why I thought it would be him. He snaps his head towards you and leaps to his feet. As he looks at you, his eyes suddenly get really wide and he starts gasping for air. Holy shit. Dex was hit for 10,000 hit points and was killed. Oh god. There's nothing left to even look at. So, the sergeant is the black male? But he's not next to her. As you approach the cryogenic chamber, you see a slender, naked black man sprawled on the floor. His muscular body is still shaking from the icy cold water. He looks up at you as you approach. Who are you? The man stands up and shakes himself dry like a wet animal. As he looks at you, his eyes suddenly get really wide and he starts gasping for air. Cat Jules was hit for 10,000 hit points and was killed. The remains of Cat Jules. Nothing. I know, guys. Like I said, not official. As far as the game world is concerned, I would not retrieve them without doing that without using that thing. I mean, maybe we can make another, but I doubt it. I believe I spent over 100 years in this place, so I might just have her join me. Join us. Director of Science. Alright, I wanted to see what I can do about him. But first, let me just make sure I can't make another one of these things. What are the experts saying? I can't go back to another menu. Stimpak. Oh, I don't think... Yeah, empty hypodermic needle. If I get a scorpion tail and a Nuka-Cola, I can make poison. Which is interesting, because we haven't seen poison in this game. One stim pack, empty hypodermic needle, and poison antidote. I think I have enough first aid kits. I think I'll skip that. Oh, I meant to hit next menu or whatever. I don't need anything, Steens. I'm just curious. It's a great resource in the game. I mean, just come back here and make stuff. Head on down to level 5, and you're good to go. So she hit. Oh, she got hit. She's gonna need some armor or something. I need to get her some. So she has what? 80. A soft face and entrancing eyes. I like. Pretty sure you said the same thing as before. It's, help me, and I think... something about electrical short. A peculiar machine. A machine for projecting only the hologram of science. Failing to learn anything. Repair. What am I looking for here? Is that Vic saying that? I guess that's me. Oh wait, that's a locker. Move in here. The locker refuses to budge. A passcode is required. Storage container. What use is an electronic pass? Electronic lockpick if I can't use it for anything. 102% for lockpick. Did she teach me that, Kitsune? I don't remember it being 102%. Maybe this thing? This security room's key card? Does nothing. Damn, though. Interested in slimming down, Vic? Ask me any time for Tabo lessons. Oh, I'm definitely keeping her. The robo brain doesn't talk. Hardly at all. So I want to get in here. I wonder if I need a higher science or repair skill or something. I almost didn't see that locker too. What am I looking here for? For here, a medic? It's like the answer to this question. Technically, you said medic first. We have a super repair thing, don't we? What are we gonna do with the Gek? Now that we have it. I can only look at it or put it down. I need a doctor, boss. I'm really messed up. I don't know if I can fight with you anymore. Jeez. He's not that bad off. Need to ask you something. Never mind. I wonder what that's about. Super toolkit. Yeah, give me that. Try to repair this stuff with the super toolkit. Can we just rest instead? No, repair. They're still out there. This thing is about the robot control. This isn't gonna help us. You no longer have security authorization, yeah. Alright, let's head back up to, what is it, level 4? Does this one work? Can't believe she spent over 100 years in this place. I want nothing more to do with you. Well, I helped you. Operating at 1% efficiency. So, Marcus. Hey, Marcus. Want to arm wrestle? I like her. She's got all these little lines. The Robo Brain might have been better at other weapons. He wasn't that great with the rifle. The thing about him is he can carry a lot of stuff. But what are you gonna do? Life. Don't talk to me about life. He's completely the paranoid android. Oh yeah, these robots. Forgot about them. Hi. Oh. Trying to find an elevator that works here over there. I don't think these work. Damaged. This goes up? No. All right. We climb through this. Forgot about that. Imagine if that wasn't there anymore. Where'd you guys come from? All right. So if we... Let's see here. If I turn this, power plant pump control. This is the coolant pumping machine for the reactor. Whether anything happened, I have no idea. This is the stuff I didn't want to mess with. I have no idea if that has any... Just in case the place is gonna blow up. In real life, I would not mess with this stuff unless I really absolutely had to. Oh, up the rope? Oh, we have been running for quite a while. Okay. So it's time to give her... I've been worse, just a couple scratches. He's pretty tough. Time to give her some stuff. Sure, really, how much I want to give her, though. So, wait, what's this? A pre-war implement for administering drugs is full of an unknown substance. Unknown substance. Huh. Really? Dog food. so... Yeah, it's gonna be boring watching me switch things back and forth. But I'm gonna have to have her wait here. Don't take too long or I'm leaving without you. Bring the robot in. This contraption could be useful. Will it just give me things? Yeah, it's... I could try to steal things, but then it might attack. Following... So she's still there. That's a lot of shotgun shells, yeah. I might be able to take all this stuff, maybe. Good. So isn't that boring for you guys? Put away your weapon. More commands. Okay. I'm surprised I can take all this stuff. Going. Bye. So instead of telling it to wait here, I told it to just leave. About time. In ancient China, tardiness would get you hanged, drawn, and quartered. Well, let's go. Sure took your time doing whatever it was you were doing without me. Okay, so she can go hand to hand, or she can use pistols, rifles, and the like. Stab a man to death. Maybe I'll give her a pistol like me. I don't know if I have any on me right now, though. This is a shotgun. Can she use that? I don't want to give her that stuff. She might... Here's ammo for it. She might just throw stuff. If she's overweight now, hopefully not. Okay, she's alright. You can't use that. Of course I can go like this. But she said pistols and rifles. Range, then melee. Combat shotgun. We'll see how good she is with that. And I should find her some armor. Preferably, I guess, combat armor mark 2. Dead rat.
What do you want?
Got any armor? He's got various interesting things. An M60. I'm not seeing him with armor.
What you be need?
Nah, cut you off. Yeah, unfortunately, the robo brain doesn't have armor, so I can't take the armor off him and give it to her, or it. Yeah, I got nothing. All right. Well, that was fun at the EPA. Maybe we have some armor in the car. Gotta doubt it. We've been in here so long, though. I don't really remember. No. % power. I think we can use this. It's car charge and more power. 100%, right? So that's what that other one is. I can't doubt we can go over 100%. Wouldn't make sense if we could. Alright, so new party member Kitsune. We need to find her armor, because out of all of us, she's got the least hit points. So she has some really good armor. Actually, I'd like to find another thing of power armor and give it to her. If we get enough money, we can actually make hardened power armor out of, Sulix. I forget what we need. 10,000? 20,000? Something like that? 7,000. So if I can get enough money from people and buy her some armor, we can take care of that. I don't know. Maybe the guy in, what's his name? The Los Angeles? Or is it San Francisco? Will, maybe you'll have another thing of power armor to sell. Not sure. Alright, well, thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.